some property of a triangle. So we have studied that the sum of all angles of a triangle is always 180 degree. So we can prove this using the axioms and theorem related to parallel line. How? The sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Let us see it. First of all, here we have a hypothesis that we need to prove. We are given a triangle PQR where angle 1, 2 and 3 are the angles of triangle PQR. So we have to prove 1, 2, 3 equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 equal to 180 degree. Now let us draw a line which is XPY parallel to QR. XPY parallel to QR like this. Okay. So XPY is now a line. So in this case, this angle 4 plus 1 plus 5, if we just designate 4 and 5 also, 4 plus 1 plus 5 is 180 degree. And we know that this 4 angle is equal to 2 degree. This 5 angle is equal to 3 degree because these two are parallel. So substituting 4 here means we are putting 2 here for 4. And for 5 we are putting 3. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 180 degree. This is the angle sum property. Also, this 3 plus 4, this 3 plus 4 is what? This is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because 1 plus 2 plus 3 equal to 180 degree. And angle 4 is simply equal to 1 plus 2 because the internal, the exterior angle is equal to internal opposite angle. So that is why 4 becomes equal to 1 and 2. Or you can say that if we just equate these two, you will get 1 plus 2 will be equal to 4. And this is the one version also to say that the exterior angle is equal to addition of interior opposite angle. If a side of a triangle is produced, then the exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of two interior opposite angles. This we can easily prove. So, exterior angle of a triangle is greater than either of the interior angle opposite. This we know. So, just to prove this, let us take an example. Let me say again, if side of a triangle is produced, then the exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of two interior opposite angles, which we have just seen. So, exterior angle of a triangle is always greater than either of its interior opposite angle. So in this figure, this QT is perpendicular to PR, this QT is perpendicular to PR, and this TQR, which is this one, TQR, this is given as 40 degree, and SPR, this is given as 30 degree, this one is 30 degree. Now we have to find X and Y. So let us take this triangle TQR first. So 40 plus X plus this angle, 90 degree, this is perpendicular, it is being given. So 90 plus x plus 40 equal to 180 degree, and we know that x can be found out using 180 minus 130, so x is 50 degree. So this is now 50 degree. Now y will be equal to what? See, this is the external opposite angle, and this is equal to external angle will be equal to internal opposite angle. So y will be equal to 30 plus x. X was found to be 50 degree, so y is simply 30 plus 50, that is 80 degree. In this figure, this side AB, this AB and AC, these are the side of triangle ABC and produced at E and D. So if bisector of BO and CO, that is this one, see, this is BO. This BO is a bisector, CO is the bisector of this angle, this whole angle and this whole angle. They meet at point O, then we have to prove that BOC, this BO and C, this angle, is equal to 90 minus half of BAC, and BAC C is simply this one. That is, we have to show that it is 90 minus half of BAC, and we take X, Y, Z as the angle. So this ray BO is the bisector of CBE, right? That means CBO, this CBO, simply this angle will be equal to half of this whole angle, half of CBE. And CBE, if you take this as Y, this is simply total is 180, so this angle will be 180 minus y. If you say half of 180 minus y, that is 90 minus y by 2. Now similarly in this case, CO is the bisector of BCD, this BCD. So what will be this angle? BCO will be, this whole is 180 degree, so this will be equal to 180 minus z. If you take this as z, this will be 180 minus z by 2. This is half, it is being given, 90 minus z by 2. So in triangle BOC, simply this BOC, this plus this angle will be equal to 180 degree. So we have BOC plus 90 minus z by 2 plus 90 minus y by 2 equal to 180 degree. Let us find out BOC. BOC will be equal to y plus z by 2 in this case. And we also know in this triangle, x plus y plus z will be equal to 180 degree under some property. So x plus y plus z equal to 180 degree, y plus z will be equal to 180 minus x. So you can put y plus z equal to 180 minus x. So this is 180 minus x by 2, which is 90 minus x by 2, and x is simply BAC by 2.